In-depth coverage of the top stories and breaking news when it happens. News Radio 1080 KRLD.
As we continue to track the coronavirus story, we'll want to again touch base with Rick Heller, who's a local expert on infectious diseases. So are we getting a better understanding when it comes to this strain of coronavirus?
Every single day. And then we go off on tangents, and then we get pulled back. So there's all sorts of little issues. I don't know if you've heard of super spreading. That's the basis of every epidemic. Widespread epidemic is only a very small handful of people, and they call them super spreaders, and you only figure this out after the epidemic. So when we go look at these super spreaders, do they have special immune systems, or, you know, what are they doing to super spread? And every time it comes out that they're symptomatic people who go into crowded places, restaurants, offices, you know, you name it, and that's how that stuff moves. And it moves in particular in the dry, in the driest places. And the driest places, believe it or not, are commercial buildings during the winter. It could be cold outside. It could be balmy. It could be a beautiful day, but it's extremely dry. And then the commercial buildings exchange that air constantly, and you get this dry air. And then a sick person walks in, you know, he exhales, and or she, and then you have this thing called viable virus. It means it's infectious. It's very small droplet. Another person inhales it. It's on the surface. You touch the surface. You touch your face in the T-zone, which is, you know, the eyes, ears, nose, mouth, and bingo. 10 days later, you have coronavirus. 3 days later, you have flu.
Is the coronavirus, when it comes to the United States, still considered under control? And do you expect a sharp jump in the number of cases in the near future?
Our models show that that this will settle. Even the president said, you know, when it gets warmer, it's going to settle. Well, he's kind of right. And it's really a matter of moisture and this dry air problem that we have in commercial buildings. So the only way to get around it is really to keep sick people out. And when you've done that, you know, and you cough or sneeze and you say it's just an allergy, that's pretty much probably what it is. But elevated body temperature is signs of contagiousness.
As an expert on this subject, what are the developments you're looking for next? What are you interested to know about this story?
Well, the vaccine is always exciting because that'll just put it down. But, you know, we've been through this too many times to know that vaccines, some happen and some don't. And SARS was actually put down, extincted in 2003. It took about 6 months. It's a coronavirus. It's got a relative in the Middle East called MERS, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. That is somewhat contained. So the interest is that the so-called media hype and all that is good. It's getting people to pay attention to sick hygiene. And we've got to get this right. Employers have to know that people who are coming in with elevated body temperature should be asked to please go home until you recover, work from home. And I will tell you that in a couple of cases, we have people that'll, employers that'll tell you to wear a mask because you're elevated. But if you go over 100 or 101, you know, you need to go see a doctor.
That is infectious disease expert Rick Heller. And you can hear more of our conversation at krld.com/coronavirus.